Most videos about the best books for business owners and aspiring entrepreneurs all say the same thing. How to win friends and influence people, rich dad, poor dad, and so on and so forth. However, I've listened to thousands of interviews with the top CEOs and unique but world-changing companies. And I always listen out for the books that they recommend. And in this video here today, I'm gonna share the 7 best books that have truly changed my life and business and allowed me to get to where I'm at and at the age of 24 have a multi-million dollar company. And I'm not saying that to brag, I just want to make it clear that these books that I am going to share with you are fundamental when it comes to your success. And that comes from me as someone who had never finished an entire book until 2.5 years ago. Because I always told myself that I was bad at reading. So guess what? Because I said that I was bad at reading, I was bad at reading and I never read, so I never improved. And I hated it and I found it boring. But then I found audiobooks and I discovered that while I wanted to do things that I love to do, like going to the gym and walking outside, I could be consuming the content on 2.5 times speed. Yep, I'm a weirdo. It's just my ADHD brain. And that has allowed me to inject so much knowledge, but not just because I've learned the stuff, but also because I've implemented. So before I get into all of this, please remember that as you're going through these books, make sure to actually do what they say and then I want you to comment below the number one biggest outcome that you have had from reading these books or listening. Now it's funny because when I was 17, I actually picked up a copy of How to Win Friends and Influence People on a Kindle that I actually lost on that same cruise. And I realized in hindsight, just a few years ago, that there was one thing that I picked up from that book that I have taken with me and that has really improved the way in which I have been able to do business. And that just goes to show the power of taking just one little golden nugget from a book or a course or a coach that you have and then actually applying it. And that one thing was that when you talk to other people, ask them about themselves and just keep talking about them, because people love to talk about themselves. And I took that, and then when I reread How to Win Friends and Influence People, well, listen to it, I realized how much that has changed my life. So yeah, that book's awesome, but let's get into my 7 unique books that I really think that you should consume in order to get to the next level. In no particular order, my first book is The 5 Dysfunctions of a Team by Patrick Lencioni. I really like the way this book is written. It's told as a story, but it's all about strategy and tactics. And essentially, it takes you through the journey of a dysfunctional team and then how they actually went ahead and fixed all the problems in their leadership. And it just really highlighted for me some problems that we had in our leadership team at Impact School. And the fact of the matter was that there were a couple of people that I needed to get rid of that I just wasn't able to let go of because I was emotionally attached to them rather than making a business decision. And so through this book, it highlights, well, the 5 dysfunctions of a team, right? Pretty clear in the title. But it really gives you a baseline knowledge and understanding of how to structure your company and how to structure your staff so that you're gonna operate together in a really harmonious way while also allowing you as the business owner to remain in a position whereby you are directing the company and not having to do all of the work inside of the business, all the nitty gritty stuff. This one, as well as The Toyota Way by Jeffrey Licker, wow. These 2 books together are literally gonna change the way that you lead, and it will make you question yourself as a business leader. It will force you to level up and become someone who is better at guiding people towards an outcome, because maybe right now you're afraid to hire, maybe right now you don't really know how to train people, maybe you're a little bit, oh, no one can do this as well as me, or you're just having a lack of buy-in from your existing team. This is gonna show you how to bring people into your company strategically. And there's a Japanese concept, which is shuhari, that really stuck with me and my team. And we actually did a book club whereby we all read this book or listened to it, and then we discussed it on team calls over a few weeks, which was really fun. So the shu is where there's a strategy or a process and someone on your team will copy it exactly. So this is what they'll do when they're very first coming on board. Even if they have experience in that area, you wanna make sure that they understand your way of doing things. And then the ha is where they've mastered the basics and now it's become second nature, so that person who's on your team can actually add their own flair to it. They can come up with their own ideas and put their own unique spin on things. And then the re is where they've become so masterful that they can go ahead and improvise, and they can even delegate that task and teach it to somebody else. And so this was really helpful because in the past, I found that when I would bring on team members, I'd be like, okay, here's the outcome and here's what I need you to do. Just go ahead and do it. And I would just throw them over the edge a little bit too soon. And so people need guidance when they're first getting started, but also they don't need to be mollycoddled. It needs to be that fine line, and I found this really useful, and it's a principle that we now use at Impact School. The next book is one that I actually listened to recently, so maybe I have some recency bias here, but it was called Playing to Win by Alan G. Lafley and someone called Roger Martin. And it's one of these things whereby you forget to ask yourself, what does winning actually mean to you? And it was interesting because they asked a question, which was, have you defined winning? What does winning actually mean to you and your company? And we have a concept of that in our minds when we think about it, what winning actually is. But really sitting down to think about what is winning, it's not something that I've done before. And there were various other different questions that they asked, which were, have you decided where you want to play? And then in that field, how you're going to win? Not only that, but where are you not gonna play? Which fields are you not gonna go towards? And that's also incredibly important because so often we think, oh, I can do this, 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 and that. But actually, something so important that they said in this book is that strategy is making a choice. That's all it is. Strategy is choosing. And so you have to choose what you are gonna do and what you aren't going to do. Because then when you know that, then you can make sure that you have all the management principles actually in the company so that then you're able to execute them much more easily and get buy-in from your team. Not only that, but you can position your company in a way whereby you're playing towards your core competencies, and that will allow you to play to win. So that book was really good and something that I've actually had my whole team start to think about so that we can all be aligned on the ultimate vision and then start working towards it together as we begin to launch a new software and as we are enrolling more and more clients every single week. And speaking of growing the company, Scaling Up by Vern Harnish is just, oh my gosh, just incredible. Like, this is like a Bible for anyone who has a business. And so I'm just gonna tell you to read this one because it's just that bloody good. And T. Harv Eker has a book called Secrets of the Millionaire Mind, which is quite a short one, which seriously, in order to improve your money mindset and allow yourself to unlock that next level of wealth, you have to do this book. It's really small. There's actually another one. This is gonna be a bonus, so I didn't tell my team that I'm gonna put this one in, so sorry, but let's keep the title the same. This can just be a bonus for the... So it's called The Richest Man in Babylon. I find these two books go really well together, just because if you right now ever find yourself saying things like money's evil, money doesn't grow on trees, sales is icky, salespeople are disgusting, you really need these books because it's gonna illustrate stories as to how you can start generating more wealth thanks to improving your mindset around money, and also the things that rich people tell themselves, the affirmations. And if you think that all sounds a bit woo-woo, that means you need these books more than anybody else. Finally, The Billion Dollar Secret by Raphael Badziag. This book takes you through a variety of different people who have built billion-dollar companies. And you hear about their story, you hear about their mindset, and you hear about their way of looking at money, their way of looking at life, looking at family, the things that they've been willing to sacrifice. And one of the stories that I really liked the most was about the guy who actually founded Hargreaves Lansdown, Peter Hargreaves. And I think so often we doubt our ability to achieve such huge things. But when you start listening and consuming the content of these incredible CEOs and just hearing the way that they think, their story, their mindset, and the tactical strategy, it actually makes you realize how possible it is for you to achieve the same for yourself. And so I know that's a huge, crazy goal, but seriously, this book just will change your way of thinking. And I think that's one of the things that I like about books, is because when you have a different perspective from someone else externally that then validates the way that you've been thinking, it really gives you more confidence. And that's what I like about reading, well, listening to so many books. And so with that said, I would love for you to let me know if you read any of these, if you listen to any of these. I'll leave links to all of them in the description box below on Audible and on Amazon so that you can grab them. Because These books are going to change the game for you. Tag it on your stories if you read them and tag me at Lauren Tickner on Instagram or LinkedIn or whatever platform, because I would really love to see that and I'd really love to know your feedback. And as well as that, I'd love to know what maybe two or three of your favorite business books are so that I can go ahead and listen to them myself and maybe in the future make a video about them. And if you like this, I'm thinking about maybe, you know, making a bit more of a series where I go in a bit more depth about books. So let me know if you'd like that. Make sure to subscribe and I'll see you in the next video, and yeah, just go get these books. They are gonna change your life.